We'll start when he gives the talk. Thanks, Eugene. So, good evening, everyone. My name is I'm from corporate sales at Talend, responsible for driving Talend business in ASEAN. This meetup is more about you guys helping, in your journey with Talend, how Talend can really help you in integrating big data in real time. So, before we start, quick question: how many of you are working on Talend for, say, 6 months or more? Raise your hand. Any experience working on Talend 6 months or more? Anyone? No? So, pretty new like me. I joined Talend a month back, so we are sailing in the same boat. Okay, we keep talking about big data, Hadoop, Kafka, so many things coming up these days, right? What's the reason behind it? Things were going pretty well 5 years back. All of a sudden, we're talking about big data, Hadoop, Kafka, Spark, MapReduce. The thing is, there has been a paradigm shift in terms of how data is being generated today. There are so many different types of devices. Everyone has got a mobile, tablet. Everyone is on the everyone is online, right? So 90% of today's data was generated in the last 2 years, right? Can you imagine the speed of the data being generated today? It will continue for next year, next 5 years, 10 years. Now, relation database or data warehouse, they're still working today. It's not obsolete. But when you're talking about unstructured data, because YouTube, hundreds of thousands of videos are uploaded every hour. If you're talking about Amazon, they are selling 450 items every second, right? People are uploading YouTube videos or using images. When it comes to unstructured data, it really becomes difficult for a traditional relation database or data warehouse to store the data and then to process it and then do it in real time. So that's a huge challenge any IT developer, admin or a CI is facing today. Now, if you think about it, at the same time, technology is evolving every day. If you talk about like Hadoop was invented a few years back, then came MapReduce, now it's Spark, and it will change in every 1 year, 2 years. It brings a big dilemma for every IT executive, right? On one side, there are so many challenges they have to face. On another side, if they have to, if they have intelligent developers like you working on latest technology, you are spending 6 months to 9 months learning one technology. After that, within 6 months, 9 months, there is another technology. So how do you keep up pace with this innovation? That's a big challenge. Now, if you talk about 5 years back, then most of the decisions were based on experience. You have a data warehouse, you do a typical ETL tool, some kind of head coding reporting. You will do reporting, it will go to decision makers, they'll make a decision. Okay, the product is not doing so well. Maybe we need to do a better promotion, maybe we need to reduce the price, but that will turn into lower margin, more marketing spend. Now, if you talk about today, if you take an example of an e-commerce company, the biggest challenge e-commerce vendors are facing today is shopping cart abandonment. Now, how do you deal with it? 90% of people are abandoning the shopping carts, right? Now, imagine if you're talking about Amazon or Lazada, if they can improve by 1%, so instead of 90%, only 89% people are abandoning the carts. It will lead to huge increase in terms of revenue for that company. Now, how do you do that? You have to make sure that you're leveraging the latest technology and you are addressing those challenges. You are processing the data in the real time. For example, if I'm trying to buy someone from Amazon, then right away, if there is a chance I might move to another website, right away Amazon will maybe pop up something for me. Okay, why don't you try this? Chances are more that I'll end up buying something from Amazon, which will lead to more revenue, right? Now, why Talend? So when we talk about Talend, the first thing comes into mind is it's open source, so it's not that expensive. Yeah, of course, it's open source, it will bring the TCO down, it will help increasing the ROI, But that's not it. It's open source means we have a big community supporting you. You know, with whatever new innovations are there in the market, we'll be the first to bring it to you. For example, you'll start working on Talend now. You'll be part of that community. For example, Spark, we have 900 plus connectors, so you'll have access to the latest technology. Something goes wrong, you have any question, there is a community forum, you can raise your query there. Instead of, you know, working on a proprietary solution where you have to rely on the vendor, here it's supported by the community. That's why Talend is the market leader today in big data integration and cloud integration space, as per Gartner and Forrester, right? Now, of course, any vendor will talk about their company in that way that, okay, we are the best. We just to give you a few examples, since we are talking about big data real time, one of the biggest companies, GE, right? Everyone is aware of it, because one of the biggest conglomerates. So they're using Talend for GE Electric, GE Transportation, GE Healthcare. Now, how did they leverage Talend in, you know, real-time big data integration? So they have, if you talk about GE Electric, so they have wind farms, right? Wind turbines around 22,000. Now the challenge was how to make sure any turbine doesn't go down, because if there is any downtime, it will lead to loss of revenue. So what they did is they integrated with Talend to make sure that they're integrating in real time. Now, so every turbine is generating about 1 terabyte of data every day. Now think about 22,000 turbines. Now they process this with weather forecast. For example, the wind direction will be this way, so they have to adjust the direction of the turbine, which will lead to more energy production. At the same time, they're doing predictive maintenance. How does that help GE? Because there won't be any downtime when it comes to any turbine. Now this led to, so again, GE, their objective was, we just have to improve the process by 1%. They call it power of one, right? If you can improve our current production by 1%, we are happy. This 1% improvement led to 1 to 2 million of savings each turbine every year, which is about $2 billion over a period of 15 years. Now think about that. Just doing 1% of improvement led to 2 billion of savings, more revenue. Now who doesn't want to do that? Every company wants to do that. Another example is if you talk about Air France KLM. So they had this challenge. I mean, every company wants to go towards 360 degree view of the customer. I mean, it's a very fancy term, right? We want to know everything about the customer. We want to understand them better so that there's less customer churn. Customers are happy, they stay with us, they don't go with the competitors. By using Talend real-time big data integration, what they did, one is, if I'm flying to, say, Thailand, or I'm flying to Indonesia, depending on buying behavior, they'll tell me which travel destination I would like to go to, and they'll give me a good pricing, right? So I don't move to another airline. That is one. Another is, if I go to the airport, I'm supposed to be at the gate number 5 or 6. Gate number changes, right away I'll get a text on Facebook, because they have connected the social media. Right away I'll get a text, okay, gate number has changed, go there. Number 3, many times it happens, right? We put our stuff at the back of the seat, and at the time of landing, we forget about it because everyone is in so much hurry. If you forget something before you check out, before even you go to the security, right, you'll get a text, okay, you left something behind, please come and collect it. Now think of effect of all this on the customer, how happy the customer will be. Of course, if I lose my iPad or something like that, right, if I get a text from KLM, at least 50% chances are more that I wouldn't go to another airline. So these are some of the examples, like how real-time, you know, big data integration helps companies in making data-driven decisions rather than relying on experience. We have facts available with the decision makers, how businesses can collaborate with a technical team, right, and make better informed decisions. I mean, so that's pretty much an overview. Now I'll just pass it on to SengJoo. He is our technical consultant. We'll walk you through the technical process. Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you, Vijay.
Okay,
so what Vijay shared just now about all these Amazon, you buy things, all KLM, all this. Today, what I'm going to show you is you can also do what he's saying using Talend.
Okay, sure.
Okay, here, who still do programming? Anyone? Okay, good. Okay, keep your hands up. Those still doing programming one, doing Java.NET C? Okay. How about doing MapReduce? Okay, those doing here. How about Spark? Spark got more. Okay, Spark Streaming and Spark Storm. Okay, still quite a good handful. Okay, today I'm going to show you the two. Everyone here can also do Spark Streaming and Spark Storm. Okay?
Okay.
Overview of Talend technically, Talend real-time big data. Then recommendation engine, we'll do a demo on recommendation engine like as though you go to Amazon, you buy something real-time, I recommend you a product. Airplane parts maintenance alerts, we have sample data of airplane part data, then we send through a machine learning component, and after that we'll do real-time recommendation based on test data. And last one, I want to create my own adventure. So today what I shared with you, you all can also today go back, download and play. It's all open source in the sandbox. You just need about 10 gig of RAM and i5, then your laptop, you can run this thing. Okay, transforming the way we work. So just ask about all the coding. So today using Talend, all of you can do whatever VJ has talked about without any more coding. So we are a code generator. We generate Spark, we generate MapReduce, we generate Java code. So you no need to do all this. You just need to know how to use all the underlying like HBase, HCatalog, Impala, and stuff. Just need to know how to use this. You generate the code on your behalf. Second, learn once and apply many. So you see on the chart here, we do traditional data integration from AS400, DB2, Teradata. We also do big data integration, moving data into Hadoop, data out, doing MapReduce and stuff. We also do other stuff like application integration, ESB, web services, Camel REST API, okay. Okay, we also do cloud integration, moving data into the cloud. We also have integration platform as a service. And lastly, master data management for a single golden record of truth. What this point is trying to say is you do not need to install 5 solutions or learn 5 different applications or integrate 5. We build everything from bottom up. So it's an Eclipse environment tool. And you just want to use any of this, you just need to click. The function will change. The UI stays the same. So you just need to learn once, and you can now do ESB, do big data, do MDM, do data modeling, all in one tool. It's all open source, free. Okay. Next, future-proof your solution. We work very closely with the open source community. Our engineers also work with Google and stuff. So everybody heard about Apache Beam. Okay. So Apache Beam is up and coming from Google. We also work with them closely. So end of this year, our version 7, Apache Beam will be available. So what it means to you all can use Apache Beam. No need to know how to code it, but you can use it. Okay, analysis recognition, just a quick one. On the Gartner Magic Quadrant, we are the leader here for data integration, the only open source guy here. Okay, for Forrester, for big data fabric integration, this is for moving data inside big data related, we are also the leader here. Okay, yeah. Okay, just summarize on the available solution that we have. We started data integration, our company 10 years ago in Paris, France. After that, we moved to US. Then we added big data, application integration, master data, blah, blah, blah. So on top here, you see, today you can download free. You can download and play on your laptop. Okay, no charge. Below here is the subscription. Similar like Red Hat, Linux, these are the subscriptions that you get for enterprise, for your deployment, monitoring, execution, scheduling, blah, blah, blah. So you can still do your own job, but you can schedule yourself, or you can subscription, you provide this end-to-end. Okay, this is the Eclipse development tool that everyone is familiar with. So let's go through that. On the left-hand side, number one is the repository that stores your jobs, your metadata, your routine, your documentation. On the right-hand side, two, Talend. As well as Vijay has shared, we have 1,000 plus components and connectors, all free, no charge. You want to connect to SAP, you want to connect to Oracle, Teradata, Hadoop, Impala, Hue, HP, blah, 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 it's all available free. Okay. Three is the perspective. You want to switch from any one of them, switch across, no need to go and uninstall or start a new application. Just select here, and you can switch between, you want to do ESB, you want to do big data, the screen will change. Okay, four is the main design part. This is where you do your ingestion, transformation, and ejection. Number five here is to specify the component of this guy. Okay, question. If I want to move data out of Hadoop, how many clicks do I need? 3, 5, or 9? Sharp, 3, 5, or 9? How many steps do I need to bring data out? 5, okay. We can do it at about 3 steps. Okay, first, on the right side at the palette, go and find the, in this case, we find the elephant. So we find Hadoop. Okay, then we drag the Hadoop component out. THS output, you can, similarly this step, you can say that you want to drag Oracle out, you want to drag Teradata out. Next, after you drag this out, you must specify this elephant. Whether it's red color, blue color, or green color. Everyone follow me on the red, blue, and green? Okay, red is matte reduced, blue is Cloudera, green is the Hortonworks. These are the three famous elephants that's running around. So you specify the elephant here, then after that, you specify the version of the elephant. We work closely with all these Hadoop distributor. We are always one version behind them. So if Cloudera now is 5.9, we are 5.8. So what it means to you is that you all do not worry, whatever the latest feature of the distro, you will have it just 3 months back. Okay, so after you specify, you put in your user, you put in your password, host name, blah, 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 you can get the data out. So you today, you can get data out from HDFS, from Hadoop. No need to go and learn 1 month. That's the, to go and script. Can? Okay. I also don't know how to take it out. Okay, we also have the Hadoop configuration wizard. Okay, you know in the Hadoop inside, there's a lot of animals running around. You got Zookeeper, la, Kafka, la, Impala, Hue, HBase, HCadoc, blah, blah, blah. So you do not need to configure all of them. As long as you point to the Hadoop top layer, the top guy, for Hortonworks is Ambari, for Cloudera is the manager, all the underlying components, underlying animal will be surface. So you don't need to configure. So this is our Hadoop configuration wizard. Okay, summary of the 900 plus.
Do you support Kerberos authentication?
Yes, Kerberos authentication, yes, we support. Okay, we support the other 900 plus components you can see here, big data, business, intelligence, cloud, custom, traditional database, blah, blah, blah. Big data components, Neo4j, NoSQL, MongoDB, Hcatalog, HDFS distribution, Amazon EMR, Cloudera, Hortonworks, MapR, Pivotal, HD. So in summary, you can say that 99.5% you can connect anything data out there. Even if you don't find it here, we also support bringing your own jar. If you bring your own jar in, and we have you just put your jar in, you can connect. Even if you don't have a jar, as long as the data source has its own jar API, Java API, we can connect because we are Java open source. So you can move any data in and out. Okay, common connectors. So these are examples of the 100 plus connectors that we have. We have traditional like DB2, AS400, to Netezza, to Teradata. So every of the components, you have what? Input, I want to put data in. Output, I want to take data out. I want to have slow changing dimension. I want to have stop procedure. I want to have commit close. I want to have bulk load, and stuff. Yeah, okay. Okay, see an example. If you want to move data from AS400, merge it with some in DB2, after that, push it to Pivotal Green Plum. So you can do it in 5 minutes. You do not need to go and learn how to integrate the 4 of them. Okay, we generate code automatically. We generate native Hadoop, PIG, Java, or SQL code. E.g., you do the component, you drag, the code is there, you can see. So some people use this tool to learn how to code. Also can. Okay. No black box proprietary software. Even the subscription version or the free version, you can see all the code, no black box. Some people take the code you want to deploy in WebSphere, WebLogic, it will still run. Okay, we build once and run anywhere. So you build already, you can run it inside a different JVM also can.
Jack. Any more questions so far?
Yes.
Yeah, sorry, I used to play with Open Studio, Intel Open Studio 8 years back, and my brain was on collaborative work. And automated tests. What
features
do you have for big data for this?
Okay, so the question, using the open source challenges with collaborative and for testing. Okay, in the open source version, we don't have this, but in the subscription version, we have collaboration. So we support SVN and JIT. So versioning and merging of code is there. Then for testing, in the subscription version, we support Maven and Jenkins, where you can do from deployment, testing, to production. We also have debugger, and we also have test creation too. But those are in the subscription. Yeah. Any questions? If not, I'll jump to the big data part. Okay, Talend real-time big data. Okay, upgrade from MapReduce to Spark with one click. Okay, so MapReduce has been around since Hadoop was around 10 years back, then Spark a few years back came along. So if you have already MapReduce code that you have learned, well, now Spark came along. I need to go and learn 1 month to do it. No, with Talend, you can do it with one click. So with one click, you can change the job that is designed here to Spark. Okay, so now this is not good enough. Lately is Spark streaming. So your Spark batch job, if you want to convert to a streaming job, you can similarly change the property from Spark streaming, Spark batch to Spark streaming or Storm. The code will automatically regenerate as Spark streaming and Storm, and you can use it. Later, our example will we have one on Spark streaming. Okay. Big data, create high quality trusted information. Okay, you know Hadoop data is all there. If you want to do any of this, explore, profile, monitor, pass, cleanse, standardize, reconcile, match, enrich, and share. You need to learn the Spark code to how to do this. Not to worry, with Talend, all these components are out of the box. You just need to drag, design your job, and we will generate the Spark code for you, or the MapReduce code, and you can run. Okay. Lastly, the code that is generated is native. There is no additional black box layer whereby the code will need to be converted into something else before it runs. It's the actual Java jar code that is sent in. So you can even build the, keep it somewhere else and you can throw it in as when you want. Or you can use the UZI scheduler to run it. Okay, this is the Lambda architecture. Anyone see this before for the real time and the batch one? Okay, so what this does is, on the left hand side here, you have the batch whereby you do all the historical click stream, the weblogs, you store it here. Okay, we can process it using Spark batch or MapReduce. Then after that, using machine learning components, you keep the learning model here. Okay, at real time where you're coming in, the latest one now is using Kafka. So you push using Kafka, you want to store inside NoSQL, Cassandra, blah, blah, you can store transform keep it here. Real time when the click stream comes in, merging together with the recommendation of this, I will at real time recommend to the consumer. So in this case, if I'm buying a bicycle from Amazon, and this bicycle is black and red, he'll recommend me a black glove and a red shirt. Okay, so later we'll go through this example, how you can also download and sandbox and play this yourself. Okay, machine learning support. We also integrate closely with the machine learning in Spark. So machine learning Sparks, you have all this that is available, like ALS model, classification, decision tree, k-means, k-means string. So data scientists do not need to code R themselves. They can leverage, use this, throw the data in, and the model is there. Then after which, you can use the t-predict to leverage on the model, and the recommendation will come up. So again, no need to code. These are all out of the box. Okay, so now we come to the demo recommendation engine. Any questions? If not, I continue. Okay. So what we are going to do here, just now you see this Lambda. Yes?
So in terms of deployment, how does it interact with the big data? Do you put it on a platform same as before for ETL, or do you have to do something specific in terms of infrastructure?
Okay, so the question is that if you need to deploy big data job, how is it deployed into Hadoop to run? Okay, so what we have here, we are a code generator for MapReduce and Spark. So in Talend itself, we will generate the MapReduce and Spark code, package it nicely, we will push it all the way to Hadoop Yarn there to go and run. So on outside, it's very light. It's the ELT mode, extract, load, and transform. So we do not have, need to have a very big server, because the code generator, after that, you're leveraging on Hadoop to run.
You have also the debugger with visualization of data, or?
The validation?
The visualization.
Visualization. Visualization of data, yes. We do have a visualization of data. It's a newest one here. It's the data preparation, also free. So what it does, this data preparation tool, allow business users to go into Hadoop, to go into Oracle, to take the data out into a nice Excel, and they can do data cleansing on their own. So it's also open source, now at version 2.0. You all can download and play with it. So that one exposes all the data for you to do cleansing. Okay, so what we're going to do here, we're going to do this simulation. Step number one, we'll be doing the batch, generating the model, okay? Then after that, step 2A, we'll be having the we'll be running this recommendation engine here. Step 2B, we'll open a web socket to listen to the incoming click stream. And step 2C, after we do a matching, we will recommend it back to the user. Okay. Using Ajax.
Okay,
so this will be the website that we are using. So what this website is, as though you are going to a telecom, like maybe Singtel, and you want to buy some data bundle, lah. There's a big data bundle, basic bundles, and stuff like that. Okay, then the recommendation will come out here. So what this page have, you have two components. One is the WebSocket. To when I click this, the WebSocket will take it and push it to the Talend itself. Then after that, we have the Ajax coming back. So I'll just do a quick view code. Okay. This part here is the WebSocket. So later I'll run a WebSocket on the other side to listen. This part here is after the recommendation is completed, I'll push back the recommendation back. Okay, so this is the studio. Okay, let me just make it more space. Okay, so this is job number one. The one is the WebSocket, they're listening from the clicking. So we are using Apache Camel, open source. So if we just click at this component here, he's listening for people clicking in. So you see there's two rows because just now I just did a test to make sure that it works. Later when you click, the rows will increase. So if you look at this component here, using Apache Camel, it's just a simple, I'm listening to my local host at 9902 with all the parameters. So this was where at the website I click, I will fire to 9902. Okay. So after I take in the data, I process, I'll push it into Kafka for processing. Okay, so now I go to step number two, the real-time recommendation. So this is step number two. Okay, so step number two, what we have here, step number one, I push the push the input into the Kafka topic. I extract the JSON of the Kafka. I do the recommendation product model, which I did in the earlier step one. I match it. Let's check whether this customer is someone that I know. I go and check my products. Then I'll write a JSON message back to push into Kafka. Okay. So the last step is into the Kafka. I need to push back to where the website come from. So number three, I'll extract from the Kafka. I'll do some processing. Then I'll push it back as an Ajax back to the page. Okay, still with me? Okay, so here you see only two rows. Let me run the demo. Okay, so I select one option. See the right hand side here, suggest product. Okay, so the plan come out here. The recommendation and stuff. So I can click something else. Here will change. Okay, now number change. So I click about three times. If we go back there. Okay, so five rows. 2 plus 3. Click 3 times. The input stream, this is the first part. There's 8 rows coming in. So, yes?
Say you have an issue while you're running this. How will you put the breakpoint and debug in one of the components to see what's happening inside this that person?
Yes, so we have, you see this is a log. This is the one that prints out the log. So we can keep the log where the information is. We also have components like a T die component. When the thing die, you want to print some message. You also have log catcher to catch wherever normal logs or you want extreme logs also have. So this all this information will be pushed to our monitoring screen. So the
I cannot break in a portion of code and in a portion of logic, for instance, in simple logic of or transformation logic, I cannot break them.
You can break them. So what you can do is you can right click this guy and you have an option to deactivate. So you'll run until here and stop. We can also do that. You can also do step by step. We have a component called debug. You can do debug step by step. See here, there's a debug run. So the debug run, you can run every time, let's say a message comes in, go step by step. So you can also do that. Yes?
You see that the
tab
is the source code actually generated?
The source code? You want to see the source code? Yeah, the source code.
based on the case,
right? You can put a breakpoint inside here, also can. Yeah. So if you want to see the soft code, you just click the code here. So this is the soft code. So this Kafka streaming thing, right? If you want to use the source code, you can take this whole source code, deploy it in your environment, or deploy into Hadoop, it will still run. Okay, so this Java Spark code. Okay, so if it's okay with this, I'll go to the next example where Vijay has shared how we can use machine maintenance, how to reduce the turbine failures and stuff. So no problem for the first recommendation, real-time streaming. So y'all can do it today. Later, download and go and play. Can I go to the next one?
Okay,
next one, airplane maintenance alert. Okay, 24,000 sensors on the fuel system help predict failure days, avoiding grounding the airplane and incurring huge costs for the detect repairs 10 to 20 days in advance and locate repairs 5 to 6 hours. So a leading EMEA airline is using this to help to keep their plane more on the air rather than on the ground, similarly to all the G examples and turbines and stuff. Okay, so what we have here, the example we have is here, number one, training set. We have a set of training data. So what does the training data look like? This is a set of training data. Just generated using Excel. Okay, so these are all the data that is good. Okay, then if you scroll down, these are the data that needs to maintain. So we take this data, throw it into a machine learning model inside. Okay, so these are the data. So this first start training data. I take the training data. I put it in a model encoder, I throw it into logistic regression model. Anybody can share on this? After learning logistic regression model. Okay, so after into this, we have the model. Okay, we use a test data here to predict whether the outcome, this is for batch testing. Okay, and the last part, we have a real time, if you want to do real time testing, we send two data in. At real time, we will tell you whether these two data from the sensors, are they providing any errors? Okay, so I'll run this job now.
Okay, what's this job? Data. Oops.
Okay, so this is the same thing that you saw just now. We will send the training data in, and after that we create a model. We use this model inside the prediction here. So this prediction model will refer to this. So just now as you shared in the slides, we got many models from Spark. You can just take and go. So you are using logistic regression model in this case. Okay, after that, we will take two data in. So if you look at this information here. So this information has two sample data. So based on these two sample data, the prediction model will say whether this is a good or bad. Okay, well, let's do the run. So this running will do the three things. Like you do the building of the model, you do the testing, then after that you will do the real time. So similarly, this one, you can also see the code and see how it's being rewritten. So I have a local Spark, so I'll be running on the local Spark in my machine.
Okay.
So if you go back to look at the job, you can see at real time, okay, how many percent is ongoing. Okay, so all is completed. Okay, all this using Spark. Then we just go and look at the output. Okay, so these two data just now was being sent in at the end. And based on the model, the first one is good, the second one is go for maintenance. So now with your own IoT data, with your own weblog, you can do your own data modeling and stuff. You don't have to ask the data scientist. Okay. So, any question for this? Yes.
What's, if somebody is what is the typical workflow like for example, if a developer starts, right? So, I mean, these connectors would help them connect the different different technologies together.
Yes.
But then he would still, let's say he's using Spark.
Yes.
The developer would still have to use the, you know, right, go into the code level and then do the Spark, you know, the part about cleansing data and then matching and the.
Okay, so the question is the these two very good to join all the data together, but if they want to take this do inside the Spark for all the matching, cleansing and stuff, do they still need to write Spark code? Okay, so we have a lot of components on the right, processing components that can do like filtering, aggregation, mapping, denormalization and all this. So those components are already Spark enabled. So you just need to drag them in, form, let's say you want to maybe filter the records for the employee, whether they are staying in Singapore or you want to normalize them based on the date and stuff. All the components are on the right hand side here. So you can just use the components, you don't need to go and code. So you see on this right, processing component, filtering, filter, map, replace, replicate, sorting, top, unique, unite, all this. So all these are Spark enabled. You just drag form, you can do your data cleansing, data profiling, data matching also have all inside Spark. Yes?
How do you test or how do you know how effective the machine learning is?
That have to base on the data scientist. So you can change the coefficient, change the parameters. How is it effective? Have to ask the data scientist. We just provide the model, the tool. Instead of the data scientist go and code R, he can just, okay, maybe I want to change the coefficient to something more. Let's look at this one.
Which distribution do you use for machine learning?
Sorry?
Which distribution or which library do you use?
We are using the Spark machine library. So we are leveraging the Spark mlib. So you go to Spark website, right? They have all the machine learning components that's there. You just need to learn how to connect to them manually. But if you use Talend, you can skip a step. You just use. So, okay, I'm not a stats guy. So logistic regression, elastic mixing parameter, regulation, thresholds, all this. So based on the data scientist guy, he will know how to adjust. Yeah. Just that he no need to code, though they love to code. Yes.
From a developer point of view, right? So if he does a Spark matching and all, so he can either write a single line of code or he comes and drags and drop here. What kind of feedback do you get? Like, I mean, for a developer who does a Java development,
okay,
this might not be the very.
Yeah, totally right. So for his question is. For Spark developer, of course, you write a Spark code, line of code is more efficient than using this to maybe draw a component, then generate 5-10 lines of code. So the whole idea for the enterprise is that the developer who does this, he might be doing other jobs, and the code, then the next person taking over might have challenges looking at it. And also, the staff also move around quite a lot. So with this, from a management perspective, it's more easier to manage the code. The next person comes in, look at the components and models, he can see more or less how this runs. It's all written in Spark, and all these Spark engines are in high demand nowadays. So the next guy comes in, will also have to spend time to take a look at it. So it's more on the maintainability. But of course, those who like to code one, they'll still continue to code lah. Yeah. Yes? So for this Spark, do I support all the Spark underlying functions? Okay, we support most of it, so we need to check which one that you're asking for, whether we support it. Yeah. So like for example, the machine learning that's about, I think 20 plus, we now support up to 16. So we are constantly building and putting them in. Last year, January, we support 11. Last year, June, we support 16. So as and when there's more need, we convert a lot of the open source people that do it, we convert and support it. So besides the 1,000 plus components you see here, we have a community called exchange.talent.com. So the open source people just put, there's about 200 there. So ranging from like PDF conversion, you want to connect to other stuff. Yeah. Okay, so if it's okay, I'll continue Okay. Okay, so the two demo that is done. So I also want to play, how can I play? Okay, we have this Talend Big Data Sandbox. You can download this URL, it's open, or you can just go and Google Big Data Sandbox version 2. Okay, so this sandbox is a cookbook, step by step, to teach you how to play the two demo that was available. So the two demo are like, inside got a few more. One retail recommendation, the one that I shared with you. Second one is a sports statistics using IoT. This one later I'll show a few slides on this, whereby the based on the guy playing softball, running around, throwing the ball, the camera will go and take this data, and we're going to convert at real time, push it to the website on REST API. Okay, but it starts from the digital part. But this example, this is how to for IoT. Next, click stream. Come in real click stream, and you can see the data. ETL offload, processing your weblog using big data rather than using the traditional data warehouses. Lastly, analysis of Apache weblog. So this got step by step, teach you how to download. You need at least about 8 to 10 gig of memory, and hard disk space maybe about 20 gig. Because once you download this guy, it's a bit small, 3 gig, he'll ask you which elephant do you want to download. So give it about 1 hour, then you will download the relevant, all on Docker. So you can see everything is installed, Kafka, Zookeeper, everything is up, and you can play on this. Okay, so what you will see in the five example, right, there'll be step by step. Step number one, create the Kafka topic. Step number two, push to Kafka. You just need to click play, next, and you see the job runs. Then all the output will be in the bottom. So this example you'll see for the five sandbox. So the first one, retail recommendation, which I shared, will include Kafka, machine learning, and Spark streaming. Okay, the IoT camera one, okay, the softball guy who was throwing, that one will be using Kafka Spark streaming. You'll see this nice screen. Every 10 seconds, this graph will change. Okay. Yeah. So these will be the five examples that you'll see inside there. Okay, so that's the end. My last slide is a Talend solution. We run natively on big data and in the cloud. It's the actual source code that we're writing, open source. Adaptable and extendable architecture. You can start small by just using data integration. Then if you want, you can just upgrade and the features will be there. You don't need to reinstall or stuff. Last one, one platform. One platform, you can do ESB, web services, REST API, big data, data integration, master data management, and all this. Traditionally, you need to install five, but this is just one. Last one, okay, this one is a user-based subscription. We based just on developer, not on data, not on connectors and stuff. Okay, any questions? Yes?
What version of Spark is this
on? 2.0. So we support quite closely, so the latest is 2.something, we are 2.0. Yeah. Yes?
Somebody is using this tool and you create an application. So what kind of deployable does it make? What kind of deployable does it make, which we have to say deploy on Hadoop, for example?
What kind of deployment?
Artifacts.
So, maybe can give an example.
Like, is it a jar or is it a jar?
It's a jar. It's okay. A jar. And you can take a jar. You can run in even web scale, web logic. It will still run. It's just a normal jar. Yes.
You plan to explore on Scala, for example.
Explore on Scala. So far, not yet. We are still Java based. So all the integration we start is still Java.
Is it possible to integrate with Jenkins or Airflow?
We can integrate with Maven and Jenkins. Maven and Jenkins, yes.
And how do you handle version control?
Okay, version control, we connect support SVN and JIT. So this is only the subscription part. We have an admin server. So the admin server will control the user, the project. We can connect to SVN or connect to JIT. And once it's connected, all the developers that log in, all their versions will be controlled. All will be check in, check out. As you can get.
Yes. What are the prerequisites you can start to set up this IDE?
Okay. What is the prerequisites to set up this IDE? Okay. If you download the open source version, everything is there. There is no prerequisite except you have enough memory, 64-bit, i5, 20-gig hard disk, everything is in. Spark is also inside there. Spark local, we have a local Spark. So local Spark is there also for easy testing. No need to every time send to Hadoop to test. So just now, what you're seeing, I'm running on my local machine. So mine is 16-gig. Okay. Yes?
No, but if say we are in an enterprise setup and we cannot connect to the internet, how would it install the libraries that are required?
Okay, good question. So if we install in the enterprise and we cannot connect to internet, how can we download the library? Okay, for the enterprise, we have one link. Download is about 11 gig, contains all the jar. So that jar you put into your enterprise, and you don't need to go internet and find.
So it's like a local repository?
Local repository, yes. Okay, one thing good, we in the open source community, every 6 months we are updating, so look out for the next version coming out in June with more new features. Yeah. And in the end of the year, version 7, this is currently 6.3, 6.4 in June. End of year, version 7 will be integrated with Apache Beam. So those who are looking forward to use Apache Beam.
How good is documentation?
Sorry?
Documentation.
Documentation, okay. If you want to have like the components on the right hand side, the documentations are all available there. You download, it's about 13,000 page, or you can just go online, each every component. If you want to document the particular job, we can have a very good feature, right click, document the job. Then the engineers don't need to go and document manually. So let's say I have a job. Okay, let's say I have a CDC job. It's a simple CDC job. After I completed this CDC job, I close this job. I right click, generate doc as HTML. It's a nice zip file. HTML zip file, finish. Okay. I go to my D drive, which I just now, this was the guy that was extract all. I extract, yes, override, yes, override. Okay, copy over. Yes. Okay. So you have the nice job being documented. Okay. So documentation on the job itself, documentation of all the components, all available on online. Yes.
How frequent are you releasing the new version?
Okay. How frequent do we release new version? So we release new version every 6 months. So every 6 months, new features that is requested by customers and also in the open source community, we put it in. So in the upcoming 6.4, we will be more fully integrated with Azure and also Google. Now we are quite integrated with AWS. So example, if you want to spin off an EC2 or RDS from here, we can do it. So some company uses us to, let's say, spin off a few EC2, do some churning or some processing of your data after that, or EMR. Then after you shut down, all via Talend job.
The API is still open, meaning I can create my own components.
Is the API open? Yes, all the API on the right hand side, if you want, we are using JavaJet technology. So you can create your own API and put it here by yourself, or you can go to our community, exchange.talend.com, go and download and put it in. So one example, we don't have PDF here, but in the community, somebody did PDF, Tiki PDF, based on Java, so you bring the component in, then you can un-PDF. PDF we have, to un-PDF we don't have. Yeah. So you can develop your own component and put it in. Okay, if not, thank you very much. We are still here. You can come and talk to us. Yeah, if you have any questions.